precipitation leads to surface runoff, which we can measure at a stream gauging station. The total area upstream of the stream gauging station which results in the stream discharge at that location is called the catchment. The outer boundary of the catchment is called the watershed. If a drop of water falls anywhere inside of our catchment, it will form part of the water resources of that catchment. If a drop of water falls outside of our catchment, it will form part of the water resources of the adjacent catchment. Be careful, because catchments are sometimes called drainage basins and even watersheds, while watersheds are sometimes called drainage divides. In this video, we will only use the terms catchment and watershed. Welcome to QGIS 101. My name is Andreas de Jong, and over the next three videos, I want to show you how to derive catchments and streams in QGIS using a digital elevation model. In the first video, I'll show you how to process the digital elevation model. I hope you enjoy it. I'm going to show you how to prepare a depressionless 30-meter digital elevation model of the Salma Dam catchment. In the next two videos, we're going to use that DEM to delineate the catchment and the streams. Salma Dam was constructed in 2016 and it is located on the Hariroot River, which also flows to Iran and Turkmenistan. We're going to be using QGIS 3.16 Hanover. Please make sure that you have the grass extension activated. The first thing we need to do is to prepare the digital elevation model. Here's the Salma Dam in Afghanistan. Let's load the 90-meter SRTM digital elevation model. We zoom in a bit, we can see that the rivers which feed the Salma Dam extend quite a long way to the east. We use our little measuring line here, and you'll see that from the Salma Dam to the most furthest point, it's maybe 270 kilometers or something like that. So we've got quite a large catchment area, but if we zoom in a bit, you can see there's another river here in the south, and our catchment area has to stop somewhere in between these two river systems. I'm just gonna cheat a little bit. Here's our final output, which is basically the boundary of our catchment area, and you can see that all the rivers to the north of it drain towards the Salma Dam, and those here in the south drain to another catchment. Okay, so basically we're using the 90-meter digital elevation model to try to get an overview of where our catchment is. And I'm going to zoom in to approximately where I think it is, which is something like this. And now we're going to try to download a more detailed digital elevation model. So let's go to Plugins, SRTM Downloader, and set the canvas to Extents, and Download. Okay, the download is complete. Let's close this. Now, we've basically got a whole grid of different digital elevation models here, and what we need to do is to merge them into one. So we go to Raster, miscellaneous built virtual raster, and as for the input layers, you just click here on the right, select them all, and then unselect the ones which we don't want. So basically I think that's about it. Yes, these are all looking good. And press run. Okay, we've made one complete temporary mosaic of all the rasters, and the next step is to clean up all these layers which we don't need. So I'm just going to delete them all. Remove. So our virtual raster looks a bit boring. Let's transfer the styles from the SRTM 90. Right click styles, copy styles. Right click styles, base style. Okay, and let's switch off our 90 meter digital elevation model. Now, if we have a look at this DEM, you'll see that the coordinates down here are in degrees. We can't use degrees as measurement units when we do any kind of hydrological modeling, so what we need to do is to choose a projected coordinate system. Now, I happen to know that in this part of Afghanistan, we're using the UTM 41 North, so we'll just type in 41 North, make sure we select up just 84, say apply, okay. Now, if we zoom in to our Salma Dam area, you'll notice that our pixels are no longer square. That's because the units are now slightly different in this projected mode. So what we need to do is to clip this DEM and also to change the raster resolution. Go to Raster, Projections, Warp, Reproject. Our input layer is the virtual layer, which we've created earlier. Its source CRS is WGS84. The target is 41 North. We're going to have to resample it because we'll change our pixel size, so let's use cubic. I don't think there are any no data values, so we can leave that blank. Now, the output file resolution will be 30 meters. Georeferenced extents of output file to be created. Let's click on the three little dots here and draw on canvas. I'm going to have to pick an area that's a little bit bigger than the likely catchment area of the Salma Dam. And I think we pick something like this, then it should be okay. And we'll save it as a temporary file for the moment. Press run. Press close. And let's have a look at our reprojected grid. So what we're looking for is to see if all of these little values which feed our catchment are inside of our grid boundary. And I'll just cheat, because I want to be really sure that I'm not doing anything silly. Yes, it looks okay. Now, what we're going to do is quickly check the characteristics of our new digital elevation model. And I just want to see, yes, the pixel size is 30 by 30 meters and UTM 41 North. Great. So let's save this file. We go to Export. Save as. This time we're going to save it as a GeoTiff, and I'm going to call it DEM.TIFF. Press OK. Okay, let's get rid of the virtual layers. And another thing is, let's copy the styles across. Okay, here is our digital elevation model. And I'm going to go to Properties, Symbology, Style, Save as Default, so that every time we open this file, it'll be in these colors. The next step is to burn the streams into the DEM. In areas where the floodplain is very flat, it's sometimes difficult to control where the program is going to put the virtual streams. So to make sure that it is more or less in the same place as the actual streams, what we do is we lower the elevation of the DEM where those streams are located. We literally burn them into the DEM. The tool that we're going to use for this is in grass, raster, r.carve. Or if you like looking for it, you just put r.carve and you can find it quite easily. Now the inputs are the DEM elevation, the vector layer has to be our rivers, and the width we will use twice the pixel size, so in this case 60 meters. We can add some additional stream depth, for example make it 2 meters deeper. and also not allow any flat areas in the flow direction. The output type should be an area, and you can save it as a virtual file and press run. Now, for the Salma Dam, I'm not going to burn the rivers, because actually, if you look at our digital elevation model, it is far more precise and accurate than this river here, which has obviously been digitized from far away, maybe something like this. So we can get a far more accurate representation of our river if we just calculate it from the DEM rather than try to burn it from a badly digitized river. The next step is to fill the sinks in the DEM. Imagine that this is the slope of our digital elevation model, and we're going to release some virtual water here at the top. It'll flow downstream until it meets what's called a sink. A sink is a depression in the DEM which does not allow the water to continue to flow downstream. So what we do is we fill the sinks so that we end up with a filled DEM, and our water can flow downhill without any problems. In the processing toolbox, just type in fill, and you'll find it here on the grass rasters r.fill.dir. And our input is our DEM, and we don't need to change anything. We don't need problem areas, we don't need a flow direction grid at this stage. We're just going to save it as a depressionless DEM, and I'm going to call it DEM underscore filled. Save. Press run. Okay, the task is complete. It's taken over 300 seconds. Let's have a look at the result. I'm just going to copy the styles across. And I'm also going to check the properties to make sure that, yes, pixel size is still 30 by 30. And CRS is okay. So let's have a quick look at our fill DEM. Yeah, you can see that there are some pixels here, which is where the river used to run under the Salma Dam area. Okay, I'm quite happy with the result. So this is basically our output for this first video, which is a filled depressionless DEM which we can use for further hydrological modeling of the Salma Dam catchment.
I hope that you found this video useful and interesting, and that you'll watch the next video where I'll show you how to derive the catchment of the Salma Dam using the DEM we made in this video. Thank you for your attention.